What is up, cool kids? My name is Gavin, I'm the Cool Trainer, back at you again for some more Wi-Fi battles, this time a special edition to celebrate the release of Pokemon Bank. And this is, as you can see, my team is right there. I'm going to have them on the bottom today. I really was trying to do a 6v6. I asked about 20 people, there's like 20 randoms in the Festival Plaza, but oh my god, even when they said they're open to battles anytime, apparently any time doesn't include 9:42 p.m. So we are on the free battle, banned Pokemon not allowed battle spot. Not the rating battles. So I will talk about sets in just a minute. So that Goodra's kind of scary, but the biggest threat here to me is probably that Gliscor. So I'm going to lead Greninja. We're going to bring Zangoose because we get to use Zangoose finally. And then I'm also going to bring Nidoking. Let's see. We brought those three. So those are three we're rocking with right now. We have Protein Greninja, which is special with Surf, Ice Beam, Extra Sensory, and Grass Knot. And it's shiny. We have Zangoose with Toxic Boost holding... Greninja's holding Expert Belt as well. So, this is probably... do I switch or do I stay? I might as well just stay. Just going to get a good chunk of damage off. So, we have our... Zangoose with Toxic Boost, holding Toxic Orb with Protect, Facade, Close Combat, and Shadow Claw. So we're probably going to live that. Oh, we eat that up. So we're going to go for another Ice Beam. Then we have Nidoking with Sheer Force, holding a Life Orb with Earth Power, Flamethrower, Ice Beam, and Sludge Wave. So this isn't going to pick up a knockout. If it doesn't know Flamethrower, that's sweet, though. All right. So Nidoking will come in and pick up the knockout. And then, you know, actually, I'm going to go into Zangoose. No, you know what, I'm not. In case it has Gooey, Zangoose needs to go first in order to be able to do anything. It's a really, really situational mon. So Greninja just died, so there he goes. So we are going to Ice Beam as well. Alright, so there goes the Goodra. They wouldn't send in the Gliscor right now because of that Ice Beam. Toxapex. We have Earth Power. That's not a problem. That's not a problem for us. We will live a Scald because it's a Toxapex. So we're going for Earth Power. Nidoking, calm down. Like, I love stacking multiple boosts, like, with Life Orb and Sheer Force. If you don't know how that mechanic works, Sheer Force boosts certain moves by 33%. But also removes their secondary effect. So like Earth Power can lower Special Defense, Flamethrower can burn, Ice Beam can freeze, and Sludge Wave can poison. But with Sheer Force, all those effects go away, but the moves are boosted by a third. On top of the third boosted by the Life Orb, but Sheer Force takes away the Life Orb recoil. So it's one of the most broken mechanics in the game. That's why Feraligatr is so good. That's why, do they have a flying type? No, he has an Umbreon. She, was it a he or a she? I don't know. It was a he. That's gonna do juicy damage. He can pretty much stall me out with Moonlight, though, so that's kind of a problem. We're gonna outspeed, though. So I think we're not going to do 50%, so he's just going to burn stall me out. I think. Wish. Okay. Okay, so as Wish, do... Can I knock it out from here? What do you think, Mollywob? Solid. We're gonna Earth Power again. It looks like we're doing over a third, though. Of course. That's not really a problem because we have close combat on the Zangoose. So this is gonna be a long battle. It's just gonna be me spamming Earth Power. It's gonna be them spamming Wish Protect. Now my question is, now this turn, I know he's gonna Wish, and then he's going to Protect this turn. Do I switch? Well, no, I feel like, if the Toxapex had more, oh, it's got Regenerator, though. It's not gonna eat a facade. It's not gonna eat a facade. That's Toxic Boost boosted, and it didn't Protect. So yeah, it's not gonna eat. I'm a poison type. This is somebody who doesn't know their gens. This is a Gen 1 Mon. So he has to go for Wish here. He's not gonna go for a Protect. But that's... So... Yeah, I think I'm just gonna keep doing this because it's not really benefiting him either. I wish Nidoking... Does Nidoking get Dark Pulse? Not that it'd be useful here. Nidoking... For looking at it, like, it looks like it's just, like, a beastly physical attacker. And it kind of is if you have the right moves on it with Sheer Force. But its special move pool is fantastic. So we're gonna Earth Power again. And he's probably just gonna set up another Wish. Well, if I hadn't gotten burned, this battle would be over. So I think I live that burn. I don't live another one, because it did 9. So I might as well just go for Earth Power. It was my last one. When do you ever run out of a 10 PP move in Pokemon? So Nidoking is gone. Not like officially, but he's dead. So I'm going to Protect with Zangoose. And you know, I kind of like when it's Zangoose against the world, because people don't expect Zangoose to hit like an absolute monster. So we are going to we're gonna Protect, because he's probably gonna try to Toxic me, because not a lot of people know how Zangoose works. So I probably should have just close combated. That's what we're gonna do here. Or do I facade, thinking he's gonna Protect so that he thinks he's safer than he is? That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna facade, because it's gonna do really good damage anyway. So I probably... What did I say? That is fat damage. So he's gonna Protect here. So I'm gonna go for another facade. Oh, he lives? Okay, so he's wishing. Okay. So he's wishing for his Toxapex, which has Regenerator anyway. So it makes me wonder, who is more physically bulky? Umbreon or Toxapex? Because that did probably 75 to 80% on the Umbreon. So I see him Baneful Bunkering. Doesn't carry it, so that's the game. See, Zangoose is a monster. And that's why I love him, that's why I use my channel mascot. Look at that. Alright. So, turn everybody back on. What has happened? There they are. I run some interesting sets on some of these Pokemon as well. For Tyranitar, I run Assault Vest. I think it's full attack, careful nature? Whatever nature is, special attack down, special defense up. Yeah, max attack, and then I think it's 126, HP 126. 126, 126, HP and special defense. So we see a Mega Ampharos and or Mega Gengar, even though I don't think that's a lot. I don't know, it's a lot of normal battle spots, so yeah, it's a lot here. See a Stealth Rock Setter in either the Tyrantrum or the Aurorus. I definitely see a lot of special attacking. So I'm going to bring Tyranitar. They're not bothered too much by Stealth Rock, so I'm not gonna bring Ferrothorn. So I'm gonna lead Suicune, bring Tyranitar, and I do want close combat here. Yeah, I'm gonna bring Zangoose again. So let's see, we are going with Suicune, Tyranitar, and Zangoose. Alright. So they lead the Druddigon. That's good for us. That's really good for us. Because we are a physically defensive Suicune. Suicune is so, so fat. We are going to Calm Mind because there's literally nothing this thing can do to us. So we run Ice Beam, Scald, Calm Mind, and Mirror Coat. So I wonder what he's going to do here. He might, like, Z Outrage me, and that would be... I would live that, honestly. This is why I play on Battle Slap. That right there is why I play in Battle Spot. We have leftovers as well. But this is just for fun, like I said. I was messing around, not quite with this. Who did I have on it before? I think I might have had a physical Greninja on it before instead of a special one. I'm gonna Calm Mind again because there's no reason not to. He has to recharge. I'm pretty sure Druddigon's special attack is like... base, like, somewhere between 40 and 60. So now, am I that mean? Do I want to get up to plus 6? I'll go up to plus 3, and then I'll just start sweeping. If he goes for an Ice Beam, or Hyper Beam again, I'd be really confused. Earthquake. Smarter, not stab, but not a horrible choice. Did more than the Hyper Beam, and we're physically defensive. You know, Druddigon isn't a terrible Pokemon. Like, Trick Room Druddigon, I think, is semi-viable. It's a lot better than people give it credit for. I'm just curious as to why... why it has wings. So I'm like, oh, it's gotta learn fly, but it does not. So I'm gonna mirror coat this thing just to kind of show off. It's probably gonna thunder punch me though, honestly. The way this guy is battling. Is it a girl? It is a girl. Wild, what did I say? Sweepcoon. I just thought of that. I don't know why. Yeah, if I think we might end up sweeping with the Sweepcoon, honestly. I'm just going to keep spamming Mirror Coat because on it, like, Wild Charge is not going to... There we go. He just saw that I carry Mirror Coat. I don't know why he would do that. Bye. Alright, so that gets rid of the Ampharos. The Rutagon isn't a problem. Now, who else would he bring? Back to the Rutagon, that's fine. I love Rutagon's Cry also. So we're just gonna Ice Beam. Like, they could have done so much more. Like, 5th gen had, like, really both ends of the spectrum when it came to Pokemon designs. So then there's Garbodor. Then there's Haxorus. Hydreigon. In my opinion, some of the best designed Pokemon out there. But it's just... 5th gen, people, not just 5th gen, but in life, people in general, just, they focus on the bad more than they focus on the good. And so, like, anytime anybody talks about 5th gen, everyone's like, oh, they literally had a garbage Pokemon, they literally had Pokemon that was just gears rolling together, they literally had ice cream. I'm like, yeah, those are trash designs, they really are. But, like... 5th gen also gave some of, like, the most viable Pokemon ever, like, both forms of Landorus. Actually, all three of them are really, really viable. I'm just gonna Ice Beam and get this over with. Who else is the legendary? Genesect is really powerful. Of course, now I'm drawing a blank. They gave us the first real fire dragon type, which was huge, because they've been doing that for 15 years, probably, at that point. When did those games even come out? When did Pokemon Black and White release?
I don't see any movies matching Pokemon Black and White Real playing nearby today.
I don't know why I rely on Siri for anything. Apparently, there's an app that you can get for your iPhone that, they came out in 2010. So I've been doing it for 14 years at that point. But yeah. Oh, better turn everybody else back on. I don't even know what I was just talking about. Gen 5, not as bad as it is, as people think it is. I think that's pretty much it. Also, oh, the story, oh my god, they had the best story in any of the games. I don't care, I'm a Gen 1-er, I love Gen 1, I've been playing since Gen 1, they had the absolute best story of any game. And a big part of that for me is, I don't remember if they did it in Black 2 and White 2, I've honestly only played Black 2 and White 2, I think, twice. But I know in Black and White 1, when you go and fight Team Plasma after you beat the Elite Four, but I guess before you fight Gutsis, all the gym leaders show up. I'm like, literally when I saw that, I was like, thank you. Like, really, I thought, Actually, you know what? A trainer couldn't be found for that. I'm gonna jump on raiding battles for the last one. But that, I was like, isn't that what gym leaders are supposed to do? That's what they do in the anime. I don't know for sure, but I think that's what they do in the manga. But I just think it was kind of ridiculous that gym leaders, like, in every game, I know the protagonist age changes slightly between games, but the gym leaders, these supposed to be, like, the most powerful trainers in the entire region, like, this evil team, and, like, especially, like, in Gen 2 and Gen 1, when Team Rocket's literally everywhere, none of the gym leaders really seem to care. They leave it to a 10-year-old kid to fight a major crime organization. Sorry, little rant. So we are 1421 rating. We are 22, or we've done 22 battles. We are 8-14. I've done some things on my own, like I said, with this team on the rating battles. So I know we have a really glaring fighting weakness between Tyranitar, Ferrothorn, and Greninja. But Greninja's really only afraid of Mach punches because it carries extra sensory and can just, outspeed and turn into a type that resists. So the biggest threat here is the probable Mega Charizard X or the Mega Gardevoir. How to handle Char X? Probably Suicune. And then for... I really don't have an answer for that Gardevoir. Because my special wall is Tyranitar. So I'm going to lead Nidoking. Because Nidoking is good against Decidueye, Toucanon, and Tapu Koko, as well as Char X. And then I'm going to bring Suicune and Tyranitar in the back. Hoping to get a free switch, not Greninja, a free switch if Nidoking is up against, Nidoking's up against that Gardevoir and it goes to Psychic us, we can free switch into Tyranitar. And I don't think, between the sand and the assault vest, I don't think even a hyper voice will Oko us. If it decides to go just, you know, full metal on us and go hyper beam, that probably would kill us. Who would he go into right now? He probably figures I'm gonna ice beam. Who wants to take an ice beam? Only Slowbro wants to take an ice beam, and I don't really have an answer for it. For that Slowbro on this team. But he stays in, so that's fine. Are we gonna Oko? Decidueye's not. Okay. Decidueye lives. That's gonna do. Spirit Shackle's gonna do an okay amount of damage, nothing crazy. I wasn't going anywhere. I don't know what you're doing to me, but I'm not going anywhere. So we're gonna Ice Beam again. If he has a Slowbro, he would switch into it, but I don't think he has it. Okay, so Nidoking's job is probably done. He's probably going to switch into Gardevoir if he brought it. Charizard. So that probably tells me he is Char X with Earthquake. So I'm going to... I'm feeling risky. I'm going to go for an Earth Power, predicting it's Char X, and that we're going to outspeed.
I am real.
Do we outspeed? We outspeed. Man, I'm good. Nidoking is power. I'm getting so... What is happening? I'm getting so many notifications. So Gardevoir. So that's not going to be a mega. Do I stay? I think I'm going to outspeed. Oh, that's not good. That's not good at all. Because now Psychic gets boosted, because Psychic can drop your special defense. Moonblast can drop your special attack, so that gets boosted if it has it. I might as well just stay, honestly, and go for a Sludge Wave, hoping I outspeed. I think I will. We are a timid, we are a shy little Nidoking. That's not gonna Oko. We sweep with the Nidoking. Oh my. That's why I love Nidoking. And like, probably part of the reason, and like, I won pretty early. Does everybody up there? Everybody is up there. I won pretty early. When Bank came out, because it was still a lot of Gen 7ers who had no idea what any of these Pokemon were and what they did. So I got a couple. I think I only did a couple battles on Raiding Battle. You know what? Because it's a special episode, we're feeling special today, I will do another battle. So our rating is 1433. Not great. But we are 5 wins below 500, so if we can pick up another win here, and then... I'm filming this after... I have another episode to go out, okay, that's complicated. Basically, this one's gonna go up. This one goes up on a Friday. The one that's coming out on the normal WTF Singles Wi-Fi, you know, that whole series. What am I talking about? That's going to come out, the one that comes out on Tuesday. I filmed when I filmed this week's WTF Wi-Fi. So the rating number is going to be a little weird. It's whatever. So we see probably a Mega Greninja. We see another Umbreon. This time we have some Umbreon. Do we? We don't actually have... We have Zangoose. Zangoose is our Umbreon counter. That being said, though, Zangoose doesn't do much else, because Zangoose relies on being faster, and it's not going to outspeed a Gengar, it's not going to outspeed a Greninja, it's not going to outspeed a Talonflame. Because it's the channel mascot, I will bring it. But I'm going to lead Tyranitar, because that's a very special heavy team. I'm going to bring Zangoose, and... Between the Talonflame and the Volcarona, I'm not even thinking about bringing Ferrothorn. I'm gonna bring Greninja. What do you think of Mollywob? Solid. Alright. Wobbuffet is so good. I need to get a Wobbuffet. I have a Wobbuffet. It's not trained up, I don't think. That's probably gonna be my next. I'm probably gonna do that right after this, honestly, because how much I love Wobbuffet. I'm probably just gonna make a full team of Pokemon that I just love. He had Talonflame on his team, but I don't think he would switch a Talonflame into a Tyranitar. So I think I can Earthquake pretty freely right now. Or I can Payback. Payback's better because it's Stab, and it'll also be base 100 because we're gonna go second. We're gonna eat that. Watch this.
Watch it.
Swallowed. Okay, when you can eat a times 4 effective focus blast from a Gengar, that's a wall. That's not a tank, that's a wall. He's really wondering what to do right now. You know what happened? I did fight quite a few Wi-Fi or like raiding battles with this team. I don't think it was the exact team. I think I've said that like 4 times. Not quite this exact team, but people DC'd. People rage quit because they didn't know the mons. That's really what it was. Because somebody like Thunderbolt purposely, like I didn't switch into it, somebody purposefully Thunderbolted my Nidoking, so I didn't affect it, and then they DC'd. So, I'm going to Stone Edge. It's probably Sash. Is that going to take me out? I think it will. But the Sandstorm's going to break... Yeah, that's definitely going to take me out. Sandstorm's going to break the Sash, so that's not a big deal. Okay. So, who did I... Wow, I didn't even turn off any of these people. So, Tyranitar is now dead. We didn't bring Ferrothorn. We brought Greninja. We brought Zangoose. So, get rid of Nidoking and... Tweakle. So, I think... Greninja's the better play here to go out and Grass Knot. That's the best play. I need a shiny Greninja's gift. So he's probably wondering what I'm gonna do here. My physical Greninja, actually no. Cloyster's physical defense is like wild. I think it's like 180. It's the same as Aggron. So I don't think too much on this team wants to eat a Grass Knot either. So yeah, he's going down. Cause we are, that is Stab, that is Super Effective, that is Expert Belt. Bye bye. So and the reason that I didn't want Zangoose in right now is because he gets so much chip damage from Toxic, and the Sandstorm is gonna cut his life in half. So we see the Volcarona. So we are obviously just going to surf it up here. Oh, the physical Greninja might have ended up being better here, because Volcarona does have pretty decent special defense, but its physical defense is not very good. But you know, we get stabbed. We get Super Effective, we get Expert Belt Boost. But Greninja's so OP. Like, Protein Greninja is better than Ash Greninja, honestly. Because you don't have to be choiced into something for you to be powerful. So that was a combo special edition normal WTF Wi-Fi. So... just to show off some of my favorite mons that I can transfer, I'll probably do if I can find somebody to fight me in Ubers, because I have a multi-scale Lugia that's from Gen 5, which I don't think will even be able to go on free battle spot. Same thing, I have a Giratina that's from Gen 5 with a hidden ability. So if I can find somebody to link battle me in Ubers, that'd be great, because I've got Deoxys. I have a lot of stuff. I might just do a video showing off some of my Pokemon, and like just showing off, because like there's literally, I think I transferred like, at least I won that when I accidentally saved. I have so many mons. I think I transferred like 4 or 5 boxes, and I'm sure there's people who've transferred more. But anyway, this episode's going on long enough. We're probably gonna be around 35-ish minutes, but that's fine. We got to hang out a little extra today. And even on a day when we don't even have videos, so that's good. But if you enjoyed this video as much as I did, please, please, please like and or subscribe. And until next time, smile later.